Have expressed disappointment with President William Ruto's decision to reappoint six cabinet secretaries who served for 2 years before being dismissed by the head of state. And as Paul Kirobi tells us, some Kenyans believe the president should instead seek professionals to handle critical ministries.
President William Ruto's reappointment of the six-member cabinet has become a disappointment to a section of Kenyans, with many feeling that the politicians have already failed to deliver under the Kenya Kwanza regime over the past 2 years, despite the hyped political campaigns in 2022, and with many Kenyans believing that this will not bring any significant changes to the new cabinet. The pressing question now is, what new contributions will they bring to help the president fulfill his promises?
I would like to question, in a span of three weeks, are they now competent to hold the offices?
This as the head of state is expected to give more insights on the vision of his bottom-up economic model in the coming days. Some Kenyans are now voicing concerns that if President Ruto rewards his political cronies who campaigned for him in the coming days, it could lead to a clash between youthful protest and the government, hindering the country's progress. For instance, some are particularly troubled by the nomination of Julius Migos Ogamba as the CS for Education, given his history as former CS Ezekiel Machogu's ally and his Kisii County gubernatorial running mate in the 2022 general election.
We are against that. That particularly pertains our institutions and parastatals on education. This simply means it will be the continuations of the impunity of meddling with the affairs of the universities and the running of the universities to the councils and the vice chancellors.
The president will also work tirelessly to make sure that needs of many university students, jobless youths and citizens of this country are met. It is our firm belief that the appointed cabinet secretaries must uphold the highest standards of competence and integrity in their respective roles.
Meanwhile, a section of church leaders has praised President William Ruto for his new cabinet appointments, further urging Kenyans to focus on parliament, which will make the final decision of the appointments and oversee the installation of the new officials.
Our parliamentarians now to do their work so that the first bath the president, His Excellency, has done, but we want now to face our eyes in parliament.
And with just a few days remaining before the appointment of the remaining 11 cabinet secretaries, prospects for dialogue appear dim, as some leaders from across the political divide have warned the head of state against engaging in dialogue with opposition chief Raila Odinga.
Tumekuwa na ile dialogue ambayo ilikuwa Bomas of Kenya, ambayo ilikuwa inaongelea mambo ya after finance act, finance bill ambayo ilikuwa 2023. Lakini baada ya kukaa pale, tena wakarudia yale yale yale. So hiyo inamaanisha kwamba hii mambo ya madialogues zote ni useless.
Ndio huyu Raila mmoja huyu ndiye alisema kwamba gari ya Jubilee ilikuwa na president nani dereva alikuwa mlevi. Tandy boy wa hiyo gari alikuwa mwizi.
Paul Kirobi, TV 47, Nairobi.